Hi. If you don't know by now, I am Angelina. I'm the chief curator of Poster House. And people always ask me, like, what books they should read to get a great overview of poster history. And the answer is there is no one book that can do that. Poster books tend to be either monographs or coffee table books. And there are a few on general poster history, but they're not exhaustive, and there is no one great text that you can go to. So I've gathered 8 books from my personal collection that I think represent a really broad swath of poster history that you should check out because they're really, really great and informative. So the first one I have is this little book that I found a few years ago at the Metropolitan Museum of Art's gift shop. It's by Bex Lewis, and it is all about the history of the Keep Calm and Carry On poster, a poster which never really ran in public. Blew my mind. And she has done an amazing job focusing on this one particular poster and how it has changed American graphic, or just graphic design history in general, since it was originally created. So strong recommendation on this if you want just it's a short read, it's a pocketbook, you can take it with you anywhere, and it's just a great resource if you want something that's really focused and like pinpoint exact. And it's a great work of scholarship, so that's that book. The second book, which has a variety, it comes with like 3 different covers, so it won't always look like this, is this book by Alan Vay. And this is the closest thing I can suggest to a complete history of posters, because it covers things that are not Western. It covers every movement, every time period, gives you the highlights. And Alan is one of the greatest poster scholars ever to exist. I strongly recommend any of his books. But this one, again, it's what I recommend new staff read when they join the museum, because it gives you everything you need to know in a really concise, wonderful volume. So that's this book. Next, if you like gig posters, who doesn't like music? I have this book by Mike King called Maximum Plunder, and it is all the posters by Mike King. Mike King, if you don't know him, he is the most prolific gig poster artist in America. And it has just hundreds and hundreds of these amazing posters that he's made throughout his career. And it's just a great monograph on a single artist and the diversity within his work. We recently added his work to the Poster House Permanent Collection, so strong recommendation. Next up is this book. It's in French, so I hope you read French, but it's a book on protest posters. There was a huge protest poster exhibition in Belgium last year. This is the exhibition catalog. And again, it's just beautiful. It has amazing history about all the different protest movements and where these posters came from. And it's just a great volume, and I really hope this show continues to tour around the world because it's a wonderful, wonderful exhibition. Then a favorite of mine, anything that Hatch does is magnificent. Hatch is one of the oldest letterpress print shops in the world. It is based in Nashville. I have an interview with them that I need to actually work on editing because it is fantastic. And this is a book on their history. And the history of American printing is so different from the history of European printing. And this book tells you everything you need to know. And if you go to Nashville, they are located in the Country Music Hall of Fame. There is a special section dedicated entirely to them. It's like on the ground floor past the ticket booth. And they do tours, and they are magnificent. So strong recommendation on this as well. Then if you just want a greatest hits, like down and dirty, this book. It breaks down every major thing that happened in graphic design, like the grid, wood type, what else does it have on here? Body type, rebuses, pictograms, everything that is important in graphic design gets its own little page and tells you all about it. So it's a down and dirty, quick study, everything you need to know. And this is by Stephen Heller, who is a magnificent graphic design scholar, we love Stephen. Then we have this great book by Ellen Lupton. It was the companion piece to an exhibition at the Cooper Hewitt a few years ago, How Posters Work. And this is like the science and the psychology and the design, like vision behind posters. So it's not about poster history, but it really is what the title says, How Posters Work, how these two-dimensional, quick little things in graphic design get you to do something. So if you want the science behind a poster, this is a great book to look at. And finally, because I couldn't help myself, if you want a pretty coffee table book, the Art Deco poster from the Bill Krause collection. Shameless plug, I may have written part of this book. So if you want just a great coffee table book with pretty images, this is the way to go. It's a favorite Christmas gift of mine, mostly because I have a box of books in my basement. And those are my top 8 hits in my personal library. So I hope you find something to read while we're all in quarantine. Bye.